Your Royal Highnesses, on behalf of the City of Munich, the Munich City Council and the citizens of this city, it is a great honor for me to welcome Your Royal Highnesses and your escort here in Munich City Hall. We are here in a small council chamber, which is one of the most beautiful rooms. We have to welcome our guests. On this wall here, you can see King Ludwig I of Bavaria, whose niece, Josefina, was married to King Oscar I, who reigned Sweden and Norway up until 1859, and is one of your direct ancestors, Your Royal Highness. So we are proud to say that you have a personal connection to Bavaria. Und ich habe festgestellt, das möchte ich jetzt auf Deutsch sagen, dass ich die Rede auch in Deutsch hätte halten können, weil ihre königliche Hohe Kronprinzessin Victoria ausgezeichnet Deutsch spricht. Aber ich werde Englisch weitermachen. We are all very pleased to be able to welcome you as guests of the Bavarian capital city. Just as Munich has always been happy to welcome guests, let alone royal guests from Sweden. Well, maybe except for one time, that was during the 30 Years' War, when King Gustav Adolf of Sweden invaded Munich on May 17, 1632. Even though Munich got off quite lightly at the time, and fortunately was not destroyed. Mary's Column, right in front of the City Hall, is Munich's oldest peace memorial and is still there to remind us of this incident. But as I said in the beginning, other than that, we have always been more than happy to welcome guests from Sweden and representatives of the Swedish royal family here in Munich, because all these visits stood and still stand as a symbol for the understanding among our peoples. That was the case during the 1972 Summer Olympics, when His Majesty Carl Gustaf, then still the Swedish Crown Prince, visited Munich and met his future wife Sylvia. Back then, Munich witnessed the development of a very special Swedish-German bond. We therefore consider your visit to our city in this important phase of our bid a very good omen. That was the case on March 23, 1979, when King Carl XVI, Gustav and Queen Sylvia of Sweden visited Germany and also signed our city's golden book here in the Munich City Hall. That was also the case for many other occasions when their majesties of Sweden visited Munich. In line with all these joyous occasions, Your Royal Highnesses, we also perceive your visit to our city as another splendid highlight of the close and friendly ties between Sweden and Munich, which have grown and prospered in recent years, especially since the Olympic Games in 1972. Now, as I already indicated, Munich hopes to become an Olympic host city once again. Munich is one of the candidate cities for the 2018 Olympic and Paralympic Winter Games, and thus has a great opportunity to become the first city ever to host Olympic Winter Games after already having hosted Summer Games in the past. And of course, we would also be glad to welcome Swedish guests on this occasion. Coming from one of the leading and highly reputed winter sport nations, the Swedish team, along with the whole Olympic family, would be most welcome in our city. In 6 weeks, on July 6, the International Olympic Committee will come together in Durban to decide which city will be awarded right to host the 2018 Winter Olympics. So as you can see, We are currently in a decisive phase of the bidding process, and that is also why I hope you'll understand that the Lord Mayor of Munich, Mr. Christian Ude, cannot be here today to welcome your Royal Highnesses in person. He had to accept an urgent invitation to Berlin, where the German Parliament's Night of German Sports takes place today, where, as you can probably guess, the Munich Bid for 2018 is at the center of everyone's attention. But our enjoyment for sports, especially for Olympic summer and winter sports, is not the only thing Munich and Sweden have in common. Over the years, a very intensive exchange in various fields and on various levels has developed between the two. Regarding our economic ties, for example, to the knowledge of our city's Department of Labor and Economic Development, Gesundheit, 188 companies based in Munich have business ties with Sweden, and no less than 13 of them have even established branches there. Among them are well-known companies like Siemens, Osram, Krauss-Maffei, or Rohde & Schwarz. Likewise, an astonishing 41 Swedish companies have branches or subsidiaries here in Munich. These companies do business in many different sectors, ranging from medical engineering to automotive to software, from finance and capital management to personal placement to commercial vehicle services. But also in the field of culture, many bridges have been and are still being built between Sweden and Munich, which is particularly apparent these days. The legendary Swedish Bounce dance company recently performed here in our Deutsches Theater. And at this year's Munich Film Festival, Sweden will be in the focus of public attention with a special on young Swedish cinema and a retrospection in the honor of the Swedish director Roy Andersson. And still there's much more. We have institutions like, for example, the Deutsch-Schwedische Vereinigung in Munich, which has upheld and passed on Swedish cultural traditions for more than 30 years. It actively promotes artists and it organizes traditional Swedish events ranging from midsummer celebrations to crayfish parties and St. Lucia's Day celebrations. And last but not least, we have more than 1,200 Swedish people living and working here in Munich, who therefore form the largest Scandinavian population group in our city. This was just a short and by far not an exhaustive list of what our ties are about, but it already shows that today Sweden and Munich are closer to each other and more interlinked than they have ever been. Your visit to Munich, Your Royal Highnesses, clearly shows and underlines that. In the end, I would now like to thank you for taking the time to come to the Munich City Hall and for signing our golden book in order to make this visit a lasting memory. I hope that tomorrow, on the second day of your visit, you will have an interesting and inspiring moment here in our city and together with your discussion partners in Munich. Once again, welcome to Munich City Hall and welcome to the capital city of Bavaria.
Madam Deputy Mayor, ladies and gentlemen, it's simply wonderful to be here. This has been a trip that we've been looking forward to very much. And now we're here, and I'm very proud to say as well that this is one of our very first trips abroad as a wed. So this is one of our first official visits. And it's wonderful that it was able to be made here in Bavaria, in München, and also in Berlin. I just wanted to say that, of course, I was very happy to hear about our long history together, but I also believe in the current, I believe in today and I believe in what we can exchange of knowledge and experience. And I do believe that we have a future together. And that's also what's so wonderful to be here, to hear about everything that we have in common and the possibilities that we have to further deepen our cooperation. So I'd just like to thank you so much for your warm hospitality and welcome. I'm overwhelmed by the crowd outside, and I'm very glad to see all of you here. So thank you again so much. Vielen herzlichen Dank.